In this tutorial, I want to explain you how you can prepare a simple flowchart, how to design it, how to prepare it, and how to, of course, animate it by going to animations, selecting the animation pane, and we have a very simple animation which will allow us to present it step by step, and we can explain each step of the way. Hello there today! So I received a question about making a flowchart and animating it. A flowchart is a type of diagram, a type of workflow, a type of algorithm where we try to establish steps which we could take to resolve or fix an issue. How does it look? Depends on the thing we want to display, but a very simple and usual flowchart would look like that. We would have some shapes with text in them. So at first, as it comes to the design part, I think it's very self-explanatory. We can insert shapes, we can insert different types of shapes, and those shapes could lead us one after another to the solution we need to make. So I'll not go into detail when it comes to the design, I'll just show you a few tricks. So I would design the flowchart like this by inserting boxes, by changing their format to no outline. Eventually, I would like to have a small gradient here. You can select a gradient by right-clicking, selecting format shape, and in the fill options, we have gradient. In the gradient, we can deselect the remaining colors, we can stick with two colors to not make it too strong, and we can select the colors that we want for this diagram. I would then add additional items, like the questions and the answers, and I would, again, go to insert, go to shapes, and insert according shapes to the thing I want to achieve here. I want another box here, I'm searching for the proper one, okay? I would select this box to ask the question if I did or did not resolve it, and I would then recolor this shape. Now I need the link between those two shapes, and the way I would approach this is by going to insert, shape, and inserting a line. The cool thing about a line is that we can, one, we can stick it to those objects and they will snap. If we don't want that, we can of course deselect that, but I think this is a super cool feature. If you want to change how this line looks, for example, to make it dotted, it's no problem. You select this line, you right click and format shape again, and on the right side, again, now not in the fill options, we don't need the fill options, we need the line options. You can see we have no line, solid line, gradient line. We can have a gradient color, or we can have a solid line, and then we can change the dash type. We can select those dots, those rectangles, a dash like that, and it's really, really cool, because depending on the width, you see, it changes a little. So I wanted to have a more rounded approach, so those little rectangles, but what I can change here is the cap type to round. Okay, now I have dots here, and this entire flowchart could be designed like that. The last thing we need is, of course, text. Text can be added by insert, text box, and just inserting text boxes like that. I will now design a super simple flowchart and show you how could you animate this flowchart in a few simple steps. Alright, this is a simple flowchart I would make before recording this tutorial. So, for example, I want to record this tutorial. Do I have a topic? Well, this time I had, because I wanted to record about a flowchart. If I wouldn't have it, can I start researching it? If no, I'm totally lost. If yes, I'll go, I'll research, I'll prepare a topic I can record about, and this will bring me back to my topic. Do I have a topic? Now, since I've researched it, I have it, and I can follow with this part of the flowchart. One thing I want to show you, this is made with three lines, one line, two lines, three lines, and with Ctrl G or right click group grouping, I have grouped them to one object so I can animate them at once. If I would like to animate this object, it would be no problem because I would animate it in sections. I would go to my animations tab, I would close everything, and I would open my animation pane. Now it's a very simple process because each thing I want to have displayed one after another, I would do it with a mouse click. So at first I want click on this, shift this, So I have those two objects. Those two should appear as I click my mouse once. The next thing I want to appear is this little box. So I could click again, fade. It doesn't matter which animation, the groups that I'm animating will appear with mouse click, with mouse click. So I want to show you this flowchart, to explain you that. And the next thing which should appear is the no, eventually the yes. So I would go the bottom side first. So I would make this my next click. If no, then this happens. This would be my next click. If no, and if yes. Now I want the right side to appear. So I would select all that. And I would click fade. If it will be true, I want to click on all that and all that to appear again. Fade. Okay, let me show a preview. What do I mean by creating an animation like that? Now, don't mind the right side because I'm animating the left side. I would like to explain you this flowchart and I would select recording this tutorial. I would ask the question, do I have the topic? Then I would slowly go, click, go, explain you what's happening if not, explain you what's happening if yes. And finally, since I'm arriving here, I want to animate the right side. As a last hint, I selected nicer colors. I selected a more pleasant color scheme to watch and a different font, Open Sans, for this design. Now this flowchart looks way nicer for the eye and I think it's ready to publish, use and overall to present.